Good day, ladies and gentlemen. Brian Moses here, founder of Real Estate Training Breakthroughs, customized coaching and seminars, real estate trainer to many of North America's most successful agents. I coach individual agents who do more than 100 transactions a year with no team, and I coach teams doing 500, 600, 700 transactions annually. So I'm really, really excited to be with you. I see some familiar names on the webinar. Welcome to today. I am added some additional slides. I see some people showed up again. We did this last week. We had some technical problems. So we're running it again, and I'm excited to deliver the content to you. So let's begin. Like anything that I do, I always start with a goal in mind. So I want to add massive value to the lives of the people that I come in contact with. That's really my mission and my purpose. And I'm very blessed to be able to be a real estate coach and do that on a daily basis. We're going to talk about the fact that you need to be motivated to succeed in real estate. Obviously, being here, you are. We're also going to talk about skills today. There are skills to lead generation, and skills can be learned. So we'll address those important principles, laws, and skills necessary to generate dozens and dozens of quality leads at will. We'll talk about the biggest misconception. Knowledge is not power. That's a misconception. It's the application of knowledge that's power, folks. You can have all the knowledge in the world. I know a lot of smart, intelligent people that are broke. So being smart isn't the secret to financial freedom. It's the application of what you learn. So I share that with you because I'm going to show you a lot of tactics, strategies, examples, and I want to make sure that you apply those to your marketing. And if you do, you'll have great success. We'll talk about the laws and principles of marketing. We'll teach you how to increase your average sales price and target better quality of leads. We'll get into that at great length today. We'll show you the difference between branded and non-branded and when to use and why you should use one over the other. Somebody had requested, hey, I want to know what's working around the country. We're going to show you examples of the best in the business, but I'm not just going to show you what they're doing. I'm going to show you what they're doing. I'm going to explain why they're doing it, why it works, and then I'm going to show you the results so that you can see the proof in the pudding. I'm not some speaker or trainer that gets up here and says, hey, this is a really great idea, and then doesn't back it up. So everything I'll show you the results, what they spent on the ad, and what they produced for results on that ad. And then at the end of the webinar, I've got some resources for you, for those of you that really want to accelerate your income. So let's dive in here. I'll give you a little bit of background about me for those of you who don't know, and I'll speak pretty quickly because it's not about me, it's about you today. But I want you to understand that I'm nobody special. I grew up in New Hampshire. My parents spent their life savings. I went to Northeastern University in Boston, really good school, graduated, and on graduation day, my dad said, what are you going to do? I said, I'm getting into real estate. And with shock and awe, he said, you don't need a college diploma to sell real estate. I said, I know, Dad, but real estate agents make lots of money, and I didn't know what I didn't know. This was my first car in real estate, a Ford 1984 Ford LTD station wagon. It was 7 years old. It had 150,000 miles on it. Looked pretty good when I cleaned it up. But what you don't know is on the passenger side of the car, I had been in an accident, and that panel was all bondoed up. So if I was fortunate enough in the early days to get a listing and go on an appointment, I'd have to drive by the seller's house and turn around and park the good part of the car in front of their house so not to be embarrassed. I did everything my sales manager at Century 21 told me to do. They had me make a map of Nashua, New Hampshire, where I am, and they told me to pick some geographic areas and start farming. Most of you know what farming is. You pick an area, you email them. Well, we didn't have email back then. You mail them, you knock on their doors, you stay in touch, you send out calendars, cooking recipes, put flags on their lawn on the 4th of July, pumpkins at Halloween, and you purport yourself to be the neighborhood real estate expert. And I would talk to people, hey, you have any plans of selling? And they'd be like, nope. I'd be like, well, when do you think you'd sell? Never. They're taking me out of here in a box. I'd say to my manager, hey, I'm not getting much from this. They go, keep at it, keep at it. So I did this for months and months and got nothing from it. Some things work, folks. Some things don't work at all. And some things work infinitely better than others. So today I'm going to show you what didn't work, what works, and what produces the greatest results based on the advancements in technology today. I was then told that I needed to promote myself. So I did that. Maybe many of you are out there doing that. Get your name out there. Get your name out there, they said to Brian. So I spent a fortune to send 10,000 postcards to my farm area and ask them to call Brian Moses and start packing. People would recognize me. Hey, I got your postcard. I got your postcard. You thinking about selling? Nope. And the bad news, folks, I got a listing from this strategy. Now, why is that bad news? Because when you get a listing from something, when you're rewarded for your behavior and you want to double your production, next month I send 20,000 postcards and it wasn't predictable. So the first 5 years in the business, I struggled. I tried everything that everybody in the industry was doing and I got pretty shitty results. I got behind in my bills. I couldn't pay my rent. Checks were bouncing left and right, insufficient funds, insufficient funds, insufficient funds. I couldn't make my car payment. I couldn't pay my pager. $22 to pay my pager bill, couldn't make my payment. This is 5 years into the business, 1995. It wasn't what it was all cracked up to be. I borrowed some money to keep myself afloat. I didn't quit. I didn't give up. And then I get a letter in the mail from my uncle, you know, your uncle, Uncle Sam, the IRS. And they said, Brian, we haven't heard from you in a number of years, 1990, 91, 92, 93, 94. Where have you been? By the time they caught up with me, I had owed them over $50,000 in back taxes. This is a sticky note from my broker at RE/MAX in Nashua saying, Brian, you got to complete this form and it's got to be done by Monday at 2:00. And the results of this, folks, was that the IRS was going to levy every single one of my commission checks. The amounts kept growing, and I was caught between a rock and a hard place. I remember like it was yesterday, scrimping together $2 to buy this lottery ticket on June 3rd, 1995. But here's the good news. I didn't win the lottery. I had no other option but to figure it out. So I stopped doing what I was doing because the definition of insanity, folks, you can complete the sentence, is doing the same thing, expecting different results. I got a mentor, this guy named Tony Robbins. I went to a seminar, I listened to his cassettes, and he taught me something about psychology. What he taught me was that your beliefs control your thoughts control your actions, and your actions control your results. So if the results aren't what you like and what you want and where you want to be, we can trace it back to our actions, our thoughts, or our beliefs. So I started working on myself, controlling my beliefs. And how you control your beliefs is you become a product of your environment. I stopped hanging around with people that were telling me to do shit that they've never tried or that they didn't have any results with. And what I learned to do early on is how to attract business versus chase it. Now, in the chat box, if you would like to attract business and have qualified buyers and sellers come to you versus you having to farm, door knock, chase, cold call, write, I'm in, right? I'm in for that. Do it in the chat box. Send me some love. Send me some energy. Go, I'm in. Yeah, Heather, Justin, Harry, Paul, Ted, way to go. All right, let's carry on. Let me show you the secrets to doing that. So the first distinction is there's a difference between a homeowner and a home seller. If you have a notepad, I'd like you to write that down. And I want you to recognize, who do you want to talk to? I don't want to talk to homeowners. When I was farming, when I was prospecting, I was talking to homeowners trying to find the one or two that were home sellers. But folks, now I have figured out how to just get home sellers and home buyers to raise their hand and identify themselves. How much time can you save if you don't have to do all the labor, all the work, all the expense of reaching out to homeowners and we only got home buyers and home sellers to call us? Well, I'm going to tell you, I never had to prospect again once I figured out these marketing principles that I'm going to share with you today. But like I told you, it's a skill. And skill is more important than motivation. I really want you to understand, Brian Moses was motivated his first 5 years in the business, but he struggled. He was broke. He was bankrupt. He was levied by the IRS. It wasn't because I wasn't motivated. It was because I didn't have the skill. Skills can be acquired, but if you think motivation is more important than skill, let me give you some examples. Imagine we just found this bomb. Who's motivated to pull the cord? Are you going to pull the red cord, the green cord, the blue cord, or the yellow cord? Anybody want to guess? I don't want to guess. I want the guy that knows which cord to pull to deactivate the bomb. I want skill over motivation every single time. If I was going skydiving for the first time, the guy on my back who's responsible to make sure I get to the ground safely, I want skill over motivation. I lost $50,000 in the stock market, folks, in 24 hours because I didn't have the skill. I didn't understand what a stop loss was. So I was doing some day trading. I bought this stock. I thought it was going to take off. The thing plummeted all the way to zero. And because I didn't have a stop loss, it went. I lost 50 grand. I wasn't motivated to lose 50 grand. I lacked the skill. If your car breaks down, do you need skill or motivation to get the car going? You're not going to fix it. You're going to hire a mechanic. Here's my oldest son at 10 years old. He's currently a two-time Taekwondo world champion. When he told me that he had a goal to become a world champion, I said, Hayden, everybody wants to succeed. He goes, no, Dad, I really do. I said, to be a world champion, you got to have badass skills. Are you willing to pay the price? And if you're willing to pay the price, I'll get you the coaching, I'll get you the training, I'll get you the mentoring that will develop those skills. And if you do that work, you have a shot. If you don't, you have no shot. Today, he's a high school quarterback. Coach isn't going to pick him because he's motivated. Coach is going to pick him because of his work ethic, because of his IQ, because of his ability to read the defenses and all the other skills great quarterbacks possess. So one thing I want you to take away before we get into marketing is that you must learn the skill. I had a call with Paul, who's on here just an hour ago. And Paul changed. I gave Paul a marketing campaign. He said, well, I just took one little piece out of the campaign. I said, well, how many leads did you get? None. Well, that could be a coincidence that maybe he just sent that letter to 40 people that aren't selling, or maybe he shouldn't have taken that one piece out. So skills can be learned, and that's exactly how I went from 42 transactions, struggling to pay my bills, to 108. And then I got the IRS paid off, I bought the home of my dreams, and I got married all in the same year. So folks, the results can be instant, they can be fast, and the secret is we need quality leads. 3 years later, I went from nothing, from not even the number one agent in my office, to top 10 in the world for a major franchise. It can happen quick. It can happen quick. So where can this take you? Well, it took me to 427 sales a year, 100 million in volume, 3 million in GCI, and over seven figures net income. It's a pretty good life, and I'm grateful to be able to share it with you. Now, understand that as I show you these strategies, they're not applicable to everybody on the call. Everybody on today's call, everybody on today's webinar is at a different stage of the business. Feel free to take a screenshot of this, folks. Pull your phone out, take a screenshot. Later on, I want you to look at and identify where are you. Some of us are acting like we're at maximization, like we're at full peak, like we're at maturity. And we're spending money. I was spending money like I was super profitable and knew my shit. And it almost drove me into bankruptcy. So depending on where you are in your stage of the business will dictate what you should do first, second, third, or fourth. Somebody who's brand new, we've got Justin on the call. Justin's brand new. He's been in real estate less than a month. He's in the infancy stages of the business. He shouldn't be doing things that somebody is a young adult is doing. We need to walk before we run. A baby needs to crawl before it walks, and then it needs to stand up before it can walk and before it can run. So depending on where you are, I would make different recommendations. But here's what's exciting today. I'm going to make recommendations that all of you can do regardless of what stage of the business, Because how many of you would be open to generating leads for free? Right in the chat box, I would. If I can show you how to generate leads for free, who wouldn't do that? Most everybody on the call is spending an enormous amount of money to generate leads, and we're leaving a third party responsible for our fate and our future. So we need to accept the responsibility that marketing and lead generation is our responsibility. The great news is it's super easy. It's very, very simple. I got you covered, Heather. Allie, I've got you covered. Harry, you guys are awesome. Great energy today. So keep it simple. Now I'm going to show you some things that are out there, right? They're unlike what you've seen before. Now, what normally happens when you see something that you haven't seen before is we rush to judgment. We go, that won't work in my market. I would never do that. That's illegal. I can't do that. Put your limitations, put your limiting beliefs to the side. Open your mind like a parachute, because if your mind isn't open today, none of this will work and none of this will benefit you. Just for the remainder of today's webinar, let's pretend that Brian knows what the hell he's talking about, and that if you were to copy, if you were to model what we're doing in different areas of the country, you would get the same results. And suspend judgment and don't be critical and just do it, you will get great results. Are you guys up for that, guys and gals? So let's show you the beginning of attracting versus chasing. The first principle of quality lead generation, of marketing and advertising, step number one is to identify your ICP. Anybody know what ICP stands for? Stands for your ideal client profile. And marketing, gang, is like fishing. So if we were gonna go fishing, before we got on this boat, wouldn't we determine what kind of fish we wanna catch? How many think that makes sense? Right? Are we going fishing for marlin, sailfish, tuna? Different fish eat different bait. The problem in real estate is that real estate agents don't think about who they're going after, buyers, sellers, first-time buyers, move-up buyers, luxury buyers, home sellers, people on golf courses, people on waterfront. We're not thinking strategically. We're just trying to come up with a message that speaks to every fish in the ocean, and that never works. It's called message to market match. When you define your ICP, your ideal client profile, when you know who you're going after, you can create a message that penetrates all the noise and all the clutter and speaks directly to that prospect. So we're gonna identify, who do you want? How many of you, I want you to think about this. What's the lowest sales price you've had in the last couple of years? What's the highest? And which one do you like better? So in most cases, and I'll talk about this today, we can move intentionally and purposefully by targeting, we can move your average sales price by $100,000 or more in most cases. I was talking to somebody the other day. Hey, what's the lowest sales price you had? 70. What's the highest? 1.2 million. Which did you like better? The 1.2 million. What's your average? He goes, my average is about 275. Well, we know there's $1.2 million homes in your market. What if we could move your average sales price from 275 to 375? How many of you would be up for that? Less work, more money, better quality leads. So identify who you're going to go after, what type of prospect you're going to go after. How we determine that, our target, is going to be by geography, average sales price, and demand. So you may have a market where there's multi-million dollar homes, but that might not be a good strategic target. Because if multi-million dollar homes take 6, 8 months, a year, 2 years to sell, those leads produce income that is a year, 2 years away. I want you to look in your MLS and find out what the highest average sales price is with the most robust days on the market. In other words, said differently, gang, what's your sweet spot? What's your sweet spot? And then once you know that price point, make a list of all of the neighborhoods that have those properties and we will target them. And I'll show you some examples here today. Okay, so let's look at the benefit of doing this. If you can raise your average sales price by $100,000 and you're doing 35 deals a year, that's $3.5 million in volume. At 2.5%, that's $87,500. At 3%, that's over $100,000 with doing no more work. Same number of deals. Now, in some markets, I can move your average sales price from X to $200,000 plus $200,000. Dennis D'Souza, I don't know if he's on the call. I was coaching him a few years back. He's in a very lucrative market in San Diego. His average sales price was $700. I go, Dennis, tell me about your market. He goes, Brian, we have oceanfront homes that sell for $20, $30 million. I go, oh, my God, would you like to get some of those? He goes, I would give you my children if you could help me get a couple of those. So we created a message that spoke to that market and made sure that the fish saw the bait. Dennis's average sales price is well over $2 million today. So he went from $700,000 to $2 million. And he sold, I think his highest sales price was $20 million. Pretty impressive. How we do this is we have to develop our skills. So let me tell you the skills that we need to develop. We need to learn three languages. We need to learn French, German, Chinese. Brian, what are you talking about? French is a language to attract prospects. If I want the buyers and sellers in the marketplace to let me know they're buying and selling, I can't talk like a real estate agent. If I talk like a real estate agent, they're not going to respond. Do you know why they're not going to respond? They don't like salespeople. So I have to be creative and strategic in my language to get them to raise their hand. And I'll show you how to do that. We're going to make a compelling offer. And I have dozens and dozens and dozens of offers that are irresistible and resist all temptation. People have to raise their hand and respond. Then we need to learn what to say to them to get the appointment, and then we need to learn the language to get the listing or the buyer signed up. So we'll talk today about the language of attracting. That language is going to be your message. So we determine who we want to go after, what's our message, what's a compelling, irresistible message that would cause people to respond, and I'm going to give you dozens of examples today. Then how do we get that message in front of our client? Well, there's media, and media is very important. Do you know there's how many types of media do you think there are exist? Well, there's hundreds and thousands. Let me give you three types though that chunk it. We have expensive media, so that would be things like billboards, television, radio. Now, somebody like Justin, who's brand new in the business, shouldn't be on television, radio. He doesn't even yet know how to really effectively convert leads. So we want to start with the other two types of media. Jot these down. Inexpensive / cheap and free. And I'm going to show you things that are free. Do you know that your email signature is a media? Do you know that your voicemail is a media? We can reach people and have a message, a compelling message, that they will respond to from your email signature, from your voicemail. So those are some examples, fundamental examples, and I'm going to give you lots of them today. Every marketing message must have a call to action. We need to tell the prospect what we want them to do. So I want you all to become students of marketing. When you watch television, when you watch the Super Bowl, I want you to study these commercials. I want you to look at the marketing around you. Don't throw the junk mail away. Look at marketing. There's companies out there, million-dollar marketing organizations, billion-dollar companies, that write ad copy for chiropractors, doctors, lawyers, financial planners, plumbers, electricians. You know, so I want you to look at the marketing that comes to you, because becoming a student of it will increase your skills. But everyone should have a target. You know, I recently had foot surgery, and if someone said, you know, eliminate back problem, that message is not speaking to Brian Moses. But if it says eliminate foot pain, ding, 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 right? So I don't know whose list I got on, but I'm getting all kinds of marketing because of my 5 foot surgeries. It's ironic. And I can't throw them away. I have to look at them. It's speaking to me. So we want to have a call to action. We want to have a hook, and I'll show you what all of those mean. So ICP is who. The message is your bait. There's three types of media: expensive, inexpensive, and free. We're going to start with free and inexpensive. We need to use a call to action. We need to have a hook. So basically, we need to have a mousetrap. We need to have a portal that we can get their name, their email address, and their phone number. What would happen to your income if the buyers and sellers in your marketplace wound up in a portal, a CRM, a software program that you owned, that you managed, and we knew that they were thinking about buying or selling? What would happen to your income? It would go through the roof, assuming, of course, that you call them and you book the appointment and you go out and do a compelling presentation. So I worked as a business consultant for major corporations, large and Fortune 500 companies. Here's an example of a company that I worked with, JetBlue. You're all familiar with JetBlue. Let's look at their marketing. So when I tell you to be a student, this is what I'm talking about. JetBlue sends me this ad. I live in New Hampshire. My airport is Boston. Boston, fares from $34. Now, folks, even though I can afford to get on a plane and go wherever I want to go, this is appealing to me. Hey, honey, look, fares one way for $34. You want to go somewhere for the weekend? I don't know. Let's call. Let's go to Turks and Caicos during school break. I call reservations. So now marketing has done its job. Marketing is over. Reservations is converting the appointment. Does everybody understand that? Say, I understand. The purpose of marketing is to get the prospect to come out of the woods and respond. So I call reservations and I go, I'd like to go to Turks and Caicos in March. And they go, oh, okay, what dates? How many in your party? And I give them the dates, I give them the number of my party, and they go, that's $589 per person round trip. I go, I want the $34 fare. They go, well, for $34, you've got to go from Boston to Richmond. We don't have that to Turks. But I can book that. We only have 4 spots left. Oh, my God. All right, we'll take it. And I got hooked on a $34 fare and spent $600 per person round trip. Is everybody seeing this? So the message on the front end, if it's good enough for corporate America, it should be good enough for you. You want to make the boldest offer and not disclose all the fine print. See the fine print? It's down here. I never even saw it. Here's some other fine print. This is only available Monday through Saturday. Oh, I'm sorry, Monday, Thursdays, and Saturdays. So if I fly Tuesday, Wednesday, Friday, or Sunday, I can't get that fare to Richmond. Unbelievable, right? But I'm not pissed off. I understand that the $34 fare is Boston to Richmond, but I want to go to Turks. So I'm going to show you how to apply this in real estate. There are words that I use in my marketing that are irresistible when a buyer or seller sees them. What do I mean by irresistible? Irresistible is they see it and they must respond. They can't resist their urge. They stop what they're doing. That's what good marketing does. It gets them to stop in their tracks, pick up the phone, go to a website, and do what you told them to do. Here's a great example, hotels.com. I'm traveling. I get this email pop up in my inbox, and it says, secret prices. I'm like, that's irresistible. I'm going to Ireland. What can I get in Ireland that I am not aware of? So I click on the link, and it says, these prices are lower. We don't share them with comparison sites. You can only access them by clicking this button. Ooh, I don't want to click the button, but I do want the secret prices. So I click the button. And then they recognize that I'm going to Dublin, and they message to market match me. Do you guys know what I mean? Meaning I'm going to Dublin. I've put in my search criteria, and all the follow-up emails, all the follow-up marketing is about Dublin. Ding, 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 ding. It's not Ireland. It's not County Cork. It's Dublin. Message to market match. And most of us, many of you on today's call, I recognize you're doing a great job in your market. You're missing a lot of opportunities, hundreds and hundreds of thousands of dollars in opportunities, perhaps millions of dollars in your career in lost opportunities, because we're not utilizing the principles that great marketing companies utilize. Here's an example of a fitness company that hired me to write some copy. They had this program, Southern New Hampshire's premier CrossFit gym. So every ad, write this down, should have a headline, should have a subheadline, should have copy, should have images, and should have a call to action. Now, which headline do you think is better or stronger, the top or the bottom? Write it down in the chat box. Which one do you think pulled more results? Southern New Hampshire's premier CrossFit gym, or lose unwanted body fat, increase muscle tone, and achieve great physical results guaranteed? Wow, look at you. Neil, bottom. Alex, bottom. Justin, bottom. Harry, bottom. Crystal, bottom. You guys are smart. Charlene, bottom. Brilliant. Now, look at the subheadline. Sign up for your free consultation or schedule your free consultation today. Nobody wants to sign up. So words matter. Headline, subheadline, copy, images, and call to action. It all makes a difference, folks. This guy's gym membership went through the roof after we changed it. Let me show you some files in real estate, if that would be okay. Here's one of my coaching clients in Florida. Okay, so his ICP is Lighthouse Point. He wants to do more business in Lighthouse Point. He wants to do more business in Lauderdale by the Sea. And he wants to do business in Pompano Beach. Those are his three ICPs. So he created a message, thinking of selling your Pompano Beach home. Not thinking of selling your home, weak. Not thinking of selling your Florida home, better but not great. Thinking of selling your Pompano Beach home. So if I live in Pompano Beach, he's talking to me. Does everybody understand that? So we want to use the target market in our marketing. It will dramatically increase response. Now, why would somebody respond to this? Pre-approved cash buyers looking for two-bedroom, 1,500 square foot home, willing to pay up to $950 for the right home. Call or text Ryan. And please share with anyone you know in Pompano Beach. So he posts this on Facebook. This is a branded ad, by the way. Ocean 400, there's his picture. He's got buyers. There are buyers looking for properties in Pompano Beach. So this is a branded ad targeting people that are thinking about selling. If I'm thinking about selling, why wouldn't I respond to him? I don't even have to call. I can click on the button, learn more, give him my name, phone number, and then Ryan calls up and converts it. He also does Coral Ridge, this golf course. And he's targeting million-dollar properties. Pretty good strategic move. So in Ryan's area, Fort Lauderdale, which is a huge, huge area, he doesn't want the whole area. He wants four areas that are high average sales price, good, robust days on the market. Ryan plays golf 3 or 4 days a week. I had a coaching call with him this morning. He shot a 68 last week. Now, for those of you that know anything about golf, that's an incredible score. Now, why is he able to do that? Because he doesn't have to prospect for business. Here's the landing page. So he set this up. Now, this is a little bit advanced, right? So, Brian, you're telling me I need to learn how to build out a landing page? Well, you or somebody else, right? We can outsource this. There's a company called Elance. If you want somebody to build a page for you, they'll charge you by the hour. You tell them what you want accomplished, and they're tech gurus. I wouldn't know how to do this. Ryan outsourced this. But there's other ways to do it as well. Now, we change and we work the words on the landing page. Which landing page do you think was better? This is what Ryan created, Florida Buyer Match. I had him change the headline to pre-approved cash buyers willing to pay above market in Pompano Beach, Coral Ridge, Lauderdale by the Sea, and Lighthouse Point. This landing page pulled 10 times better than this landing page because it spoke to the market, right? It spoke to their market. Here's a client in Ontario. So this is a non-branded ad where they have a business page called Ontario Real Estate Market. So everybody listening on today's webinar can create a business page, but it doesn't have to be Brian Moses at Coldwell Banker. I have that one too, and there's a time and place to use that one. But if I want to attract leads, people don't want to talk to a salesperson. So I'm going to try to fly under the radar a little bit. Here's one in Gulf Shores, Alabama. So they create a business page called Gulf Shores Real Estate and Community Updates, selling your Gulf Shores home. Find out what it's worth instantly. Click, and they end up on a home value site, which I'll show you in a minute. They enter their address, and now the mouse is in the mousetrap. We have their address. That's called the partial lead. How many of you would give your left arm to just have partial leads? That's all the addresses in your area. You don't have their name. You don't have their phone number. But you'd be okay with the addresses of people that are selling their home in your market. That beats the shit out of door knocking, folks, trying to find the one or two people in a neighborhood that are selling. So addresses are powerful. We can then create drip campaigns. We can reverse look up their phone numbers. We could show up at their doorstep, tell them that we understand that they're thinking about selling, and offer them a free market evaluation. And that's how we build our business. Oh, whew, going fast. Nevin Hollett, he's a boss, top 50 agent in all of Canada. Royal LePage superstar. He sells real estate on an island, on a rock, Newfoundland. Like, it is granite, it's rock. He sold 189 homes last year. And the best part, the best thing about Nevin, and I want everybody to understand this, is he doesn't work any harder than you do. He probably takes more time off than most of the people on this webinar. Why? Because he's talking to people that are selling their home, not random people. And when you're talking to qualified people, you work less and you make more money. Nevin plays a lot of golf. He took 4 or 5 vacations last year. He made over $1 million in commissions. So here's his message. He created a business page. He's targeting Mount Pearl, CBS, Paradise, and he drives them to a landing page. So here's his landing page. They enter their address. They're in the mousetrap. Now, understand there are many technology companies that purport to do this for you. Yeah, absolutely, Heather. Nevin is the best. He's amazing. And he'd give you the shirt off his back. Truly a great guy. So when you enter your address, Nevin gets your address. There's a step two, though, that says so that we can send you the report. Who do we send it to? Well, send it to Brian Moses. Send it to my address. Here's my email address. You can send me a PDF to my email address. And if we have any questions so that we get you the right market report, what's the number we can call you at? So Nevin gets partial leads, but he also gets a shit ton of full leads. And he's targeting not everybody in Newfoundland, but just three areas, Mount Pearl, CBS, and Paradise. He created a business page on social media. Want to sell your Paradise home? Find out what it's worth, and he drives them to his landing page. Folks, it's that easy. I told you I would produce results, right? So here's a look behind what Nevin did. He was so excited, he sent me this screenshot. He said, Brian, I spent $89, okay, for these three campaigns, $22 in CBS, $21 in Paradise, $43 in the third market, total of 89, and here's what I got. I got 61 full leads, that's name, email address, phone number, property address, and 113 partial leads. How many of you, right in the box, say I would spend $90 for 174 leads? How many of you are spending more than $90 for 174 leads? But here's the difference. You got to take control of your marketing. You can't outsource it. Here's a guy in Maine, Nick Danbury, great guy. Branded ad versus non-branded. He's Falmouth and Portland are his markets. Guess which ad pulled better? The one on the top or the one on the bottom? Both very similar markets. He works in Portland. He works in Falmouth. Someone, Thomas, you're spending way more. The one on the bottom pulls more because it's non-branded. It's less branded. Now, just so that you all know, we don't have time to get into the details today, but all of these ads are in full compliance. I always get the question, Brian, can you run these ads? Yes, the law says that you must disclose that you're a real estate agent, and we do. We do it on the main real estate and community updates page. We don't do it in the ad, though. So if anybody were to say, hey, you're not disclosing, yes, we are. Let me show you where, and we show them. Here's a guy in Wilmington, North Carolina. He ran this ad for 27 days. So from the 1st of January to the 28th, he reached 7,000 people, spent $128. He got 120 people to click on his page, but here's what he got. 67 total leads, 16 full, 5 conversations, 3 appointments. How many think that's good? Here's Phil Slazak. He's in Raleigh, North Carolina. This is a one-month screenshot. He got 300 clicks to his website up here in the top left. He reached 18,000 people in his community, saw the ad, but 300 people out of the 18,000 clicked. Do you know what that means? 18,100 aren't selling their house. He doesn't want to talk to them. So he spent $315 to get 300 people to his website, and it resulted in about 125, 130 leads. Half of them were full, half of them were partials. Here's something everybody could do right away today. So here's Melissa Samsell. This is her Facebook post. She posted 2,400 square foot, 2-car garage, fixer-uppers. We've got buyers willing to pay top dollar for the right home. They're looking for 2,400 square feet. Call Jessica. Look at this. I call this the one-hour lead magnet. We will be listing ours in 2 weeks. Melissa deleted this. Private message Katie, turned it into a listing appointment and got the listing and ended up making $21,000 on a free post on Facebook. Let's look at some examples of media again. And I know I'm talking fast. I'm going to give you an opportunity to ask some questions. I'll go until I've got no more gas or nobody on the call. I want to really make a difference in your life. So there's three types of media: expensive, inexpensive, and free. How about a free buyer or seller seminar? I would do a seller seminar 4 times a year, and we would get 15 people to come to my office. 15 people. That's 60 sellers on 4 times a year, roughly 8 to 10 hours of my time. How many of you would spend 10 hours to get 60 listing presentations? So I do a listing presentation at the seller seminar. And today I help coaching clients set these up in their marketplace. And this was done, you know, quite a few years ago, and we got 15 people. The ones that we're doing today are producing 40, 50, 60 active sellers in their market because I understand marketing a lot better than I did back in 2001. Let's look at another inexpensive media, business cards. How many of you use business cards in your marketing? How many of you have seen these bulletin boards at the gas station or at the restaurant or at the supermarket? So what do people do? Put their business cards up. How much business do you get when you put your business card on here? I've never got this to work, yet we keep doing it. So the problem is nobody wants to deal with a salesperson. You know, and there's real estate agents on this card. Here's one right here, Keller Williams agent right here. Nobody's going to call her to buy or sell a house. There's no shortage of real estate agents. So instead, we use the media of business cards to create a message that speaks to our target audience and gives them a hook where they can go in and find out what their home is worth or go and search properties. Now on the back, we put all our disclosure information, you know, the company name, Century 21, Coldwell Banker, our real estate license number, and we put that on the back of the card. But you can print out 1,000 of these for about $50. How many of you will spend $50 to have your message peppered all over town? I went fishing with my son in Miami once, and I go, hey, when can we drop the lines in the water? They go, wait a minute. And he threw some chum overboard. The chum attracts the fish to the surface, attracts the fish. They smell the chum. This is chum. Let's distribute these all over our market. We can take that same concept, that same message, and find inexpensive ways in our community to distribute that message. This is a breakfast placemat in one of my surrounding neighborhoods or surrounding towns. Great little restaurant. It's not an inexpensive place to go. And look, real estate agent. Are they likely to get any business from this? Folks, the goal of marketing is not to promote yourself. Please write that down. Don't promote yourself, but lead generate. We don't want to promote. We want to lead generate. So instead of putting my business card, I would put selling your New Hampshire home this year. Find out what it's worth instantly. Visit NewHampshireHomePrices.com. Somebody who resonates with that message would tear that off, go home, and turn into a lead. Here's a client that I have up on Lake Winnipesaukee in New Hampshire. He put this in a breakfast placemat. Here's a liturgical publication. For less than $200 a year, I can be in a liturgical publication that reaches thousands and thousands of parishioners. Great, inexpensive way to get your message in front of people. Here's another great message. How to prepare your kids for a move. Free report. Folks, let me ask you, who would want a report on how to prepare your young children for a move? Huh, people that are selling. Guess what? When people are selling, you send the report and you turn them into a market evaluation. Here's some others. Free report, how to get more money for your home. Here's another media. My son goes to a private school. It's not inexpensive to go to that school. The parents of his classmates likely live in a nice home in a nice community. Likely are my ideal clients. So for $100, I can put a business card ad in the Bishop Gurdon football program. I could put it in the hockey program, in the cheerleading manual. I could put it at the graduation program. For $100 and reach thousands and thousands of people with a good, compelling message. Here's a client that is targeting apartment complexes and putting this in the laundromat around the apartment complexes or in the mailroom at the apartment complexes. He created a little care sheet, very, very ingenious, very strategic, generates leads. These are door hangers, not expensive. Folks, if you're doing just listed and just sold postcards, don't. That's what everybody does. If you want the results that everybody else has, then do just listed and just sold postcards. The average agent in the United States last year sold 5 houses. So if you want those results, do what they're doing. If you want to sell 100, 200 homes or more, build a team, grow your business, do this stuff. Very, very easy. This one little sticker produced 500 to 700 leads. I don't remember off the top of my head. It was a couple of years ago. It's a sticker that went to 50,000 households in the Triangle area in Raleigh, North Carolina. 50,000 households. Of 50,000 households, many of those people are thinking about selling. So he put a sticker on the front of the newspaper. It was an expensive campaign. I think he spent a couple thousand dollars, but he generated 500 to 700 leads. Folks, it's easy. Here's a woman in Canada, Durham Real Estate Values. So people say, will this work in Canada? Yep, it'll work anywhere. Now, Brandon, what are you doing to generate leads? Here's a woman in my market. I get her emails. I only pulled it out because there's no reason for me to call her. This is horrible marketing. She even spelt my name wrong. Brianne. Not good. I'm not going to respond to this. No, The more successful you are at lead generation, the less follow-up you have to do. How many of you would like the sellers to chase you? Would you like the sellers to chase you? I'm going to show you how to create a seller message where you don't even have to call them back. And if you don't call them back, they'll keep calling you. How powerful would that be? You know why I created that message? Because follow-up sucks. I don't want to chase people. So here's a great one. Sell your home without listing it. Remember I said French, German, Chinese? Right? We need to speak a different language. Do you think I really want to sell someone's house without listing it? Of course not. So I make the boldest offer I can make. I could sell your home without listing it. What this really means is the sun, the earth, the stars all have to come in alignment. And the likelihood that I have a buyer for their house is pretty slim. But I get them to call me to go, hey, how does this work? And then I go, well, if I have a buyer, you don't have to list your home. We'll just sell it to my buyer. And they go, oh, cool. Hey, when can I come and take a look at your property? Well, why don't you just bring your buyer, Brian? Well, I actually have more than one buyer. What I found works better is rather than traipse people through your house that may not have no interest in it, let me come by, take a look, and I'll keep it in mind. And if I don't have anybody, I'll let you know. Now I go through there, I have a listing appointment, folks. And I tell them straight up, I don't have a buyer for your house. And I tell them why that's a good thing. Why is that a good thing? Well, because price is a function of supply and demand. And if I had a buyer, they're calling the shots. It's one buyer. But if I can get demand up on your home, if I could create lots of activity, get a bidding war going on your home, can you see where that would be an advantage, Mr. Seller? Well, yeah, that makes sense, Brian. Well, let me show you how I do that. Can I show you our marketing and how we get lots of people interested in your home? Sure, that sounds good. We weren't ready to sell our house, but yeah, go ahead. Now I'm into a listing presentation. This campaign's being used all over North America and crushing it for lead generation. It's a branded campaign. We don't have to be sneaky. We're going after the low-hanging fruit. How many people in your market are about to sell their home right now today? They're about to list their home with Coldwell Banker, Century 21, Keller Williams, Roy LePage, Sutton Group, ERA, another company. And then they see this message and they go, hold on, honey. Before we call that ERA agent who's in our country club, call Matt. He's got buyers that are pre-approved looking in our area, folks. And then if you don't call them back, they'll call you again. Hey, I left you a message. Pretty fun, folks. Here's another one. So when I work with clients, I look at everything, right? Words matter. They make a difference. Your free home estimate versus maximize the selling price of your Encinitas home. The one on the bottom pulled way better. Because the one on the top didn't speak to the people in Encinitas. If you guys have any questions, guys and ladies, feel free to put them in the chat box. We're moving right along, but I want to give you as much as I possibly can. I also want to share with you some resources and show you some examples of how you can do this immediately. But Matt, this is an example of a little writer in a newspaper here. Jeremy's using a postcard. Here's the backside of the postcard. Here's Chris Sarita in British Columbia. Chris in Kelowna is using this campaign. Postcards are a little expensive. There are other media that are less expensive. You can do this on Facebook, on social media. Look at the Rocket Sisters. Do you want to sell your home without having to list it? This costs nothing. Costs nothing. Now, it would cost a little bit more if she boosted it, if she put some ad spend behind it, but still a lot less than postcards. Here's Nevin again, superstar agent, 189 sales, top 50. He posted this on Instagram, texted me, Brian, I can't believe this shit. I can't believe this is working. I've been promoting myself for 10 years and getting nothing. I run this and I get seller leads. Pretty cool. We need hooks, though, folks, because I don't want you having to sit by the telephone 24/7 waiting for people waiting for people to call you when you have families, when you want to play golf, when you want to do other things. So my hooks capture the leads. Here's what it looks like. We should have a landing page. There are subscription-based companies out there. You don't need to go out and build a website. There's companies doing this. I will caution you, though, these companies are tech companies, and words make a difference. So you can change the wording on the landing page and dramatically increase the results. There's different looks, different feels. I have my preferences as which ones I like. I stay away from words that are threatening and scary. And I'm very, very critical on the messaging that I put on my ads and on my landing pages, and you should be too. But what I'm really getting at is you need to become a student of marketing. Here's Dennis D'Souza, another great agent, very, very successful. I mentioned him earlier, moving his average sales price from 700 to like 2 million in San Diego. If he wants buyers, he gives them a place to search for listings. When they go to search the listings, they get to see what's available, and then there's a hook. Oh my God, for me to get more, I got to give you my name, my email, and my phone number. So Dennis does this. It's loaded with lots of benefits, free access to all the MLS, full control of your home search, just like a real estate agent. And he generates hundreds and hundreds of buyer leads each and every month. And then do you know what you have the luxury of doing, gang? You have the luxury of picking and choosing who you want to work with. I spoke with someone the other day. They generated like 10 leads their first day. I go, don't call all 10. What? Don't call all of them? No, call the top six. How do you know which one's the top? Based on your average sales price. So he goes, oh my God, I have a $50,000 lead in here. Throw it away. The ability to generate lots of leads allows you to be in control of your business. Here's an agent in Wisconsin. We just wrote this. We're looking for sellers. So Watertown homeowners, if you have stainless steel appliances, your home could be worth more than your neighbor's. Oh my God, I have stainless steel appliances. By the way, that's her ICP. She wants nice homes with nice kitchens. They sell in 2 days. This is a great story, folks. I'm working with a young man who graduated high school last year, doesn't want to go to college, wants to be a real estate professional. I'm coaching him. We created this ad, free list of Groton, Dunstable, and Ayr bank foreclosures. Now, there's not a lot of bank foreclosures in our market today, but bank foreclosures is the cheese in the mousetrap. It's the peanut butter. It's the irresistible word. It's French. We need to learn different languages. So buyer sees this, 48 homes to choose from, 400 to 700. Oh my God, sign me up. They fill out their email address, they fill out their name, and they put in their phone number. Then they get an email that says, thank you. We will contact you in the next 24 hours so we don't fill your inbox up with a bunch of properties that don't match your criteria. In the meantime, give some consideration to the pounds, price points, and amenities so that we can actually get you those listings that best match your criteria. Now, when I called them and they wanted the foreclosures, what I'm going to articulate to them is that, A, there's not a lot of foreclosures. Well, it says there's over 48 to choose from. Well, there's over 48 homes to choose from between 400 and 700,000. Would you like all the properties that match your criteria, or do you just want one occasional bank foreclosure? No, we'd like them all. Oh, great. When can we get together so we get you set up? It's that easy, folks. Now, some of you, your mind is not open. You're going, well, that's bait and switch. It's not. It's not bait and switch. If we have foreclosures, we can give them to them. But let's do one better than that. Let's give them everything that matches their criteria. Have you ever had a buyer call you on a three-bedroom house, but they need four bedrooms? You take them out and show them four-bedroom homes. That's not bait and switch. They called on one hook, three bedrooms, and they ended up buying a four-bedroom. I have generated hundreds of leads over my career, people that have responded to bank foreclosures and never bought a bank foreclosure. But they're better off because they're working with me. Now, in Justin's case, he just did this ad from February 11th to the 18th. So here we are, the 15th, it's only been running 4 days. He put $5 behind it. Hey, he's 19, he's got a small budget. Do you guys want to see the results? $5 a day? Within the first hour, he had generated one lead for $1.16. He reached 60 people on Facebook, generated one lead. 2 days later, he had seven leads, and two of them are seller leads. Five are buyers, two of them are buyers and sellers. So that's really nine potential real estate transactions. Justin knows what to say when he calls them back. He's going to book an appointment. And this kid is going to make over $100,000 at 19 years old this first year in the business. How many of you like that recipe? Any questions? I see some comments here. Thanks, Thomas. I appreciate it. Don, driving them to my website from the Facebook ads. So, Don, you can drive them to your website. Yes. I'd want to see the landing page to make sure that there's nothing in there that's going to cause them to run away. Or you can have them sign up, Don. So here we have them sign up, and it looks like this. So in order to receive the bank foreclosures, sign up to, by providing your info below. Well, if I want the bank foreclosures and I want the free list of 48 properties from 400 to 700,000, this makes sense. I hit submit and it translates to become a lead. So you can do it either way. There's multiple ways to create a hook. You can drive them to a website, you can have them sign up, you can have them call you. What about Google pay-per-click? Great question, Harry. I'm not an expert at it. It's way above my pay grade. What I have found is that I can generate leads for a lot less money than Google pay-per-click, and they're better quality of leads. So I'm not saying it's a bad thing. There's some services out there that will put some money to Google pay-per-click. And if you're getting good leads and you're converting and it's profitable, then continue doing it. But if it's not, don't keep doing it, right? That's the definition of insanity. Any other questions? Any other questions? Okay, let me show you a short video. How many of you are willing to change your marketing words to get more leads, to do a better job of being the predominant agent in your marketplace? And when you do that, when you change your words, you get all the riches, all the gold. So let's talk a little bit about branding and self-promotion. It's the last thing that I do. I use free and inexpensive strategies. And then I take the profits from those sales and those returns on my investment, and I invest them for compounded returns. And I am all over the place in my marketplace. There's branding everywhere. You can't get away from me without thinking about Brian Moses as a real estate agent. But just because everybody knows who I am, I got to be honest with you and tell you that I only had 5% of the market. So at 400 sales a year, it only represented 5% of the market. What does that mean? That all this money that I spent on branding and promotion isn't nearly as effective, doesn't nearly as produce as many sales as the direct response examples that I showed you today. So let me tell you this, gang, and I'll wrap it up with this and offer you some direction and some resources so that you can turn this on immediately. There are two worlds that people live in. One is the reported world. Well, I can't do that. I don't understand. My broker won't let me. That won't work in my market. That's the reported world. We have a lot of competition. And then the other world on the right is the created world. I'm going to suggest you do what Brian Moses did and you jump from the reported world with all the reasons and excuses why we can't succeed, why we have limitations, and you create the world that you want. I told a guy at lunch, I don't know, some 1992, 1993, when I was asked, what is my goal? My goal is to be the number one real estate salesperson in the world for Coldwell Banker. He laughed. He spit up his coffee. He goes, how are you going to do that? You're not even the number one agent in your office. You haven't even sold 50 homes a year. He was living in the reported world. I was living in the created world. You know, life is more than lead generation. It's more than sales. It's about what real estate really can afford you is the opportunity to live the life that you've always dreamed of. You know, one day you'll wake up and there won't be any more time to do the things you wanted to do. One of the greatest things about real estate is when you can make $100,000, $200,000 a year, $500,000 a year, more than $500,000 a year, $1 million a year, you can live a pretty amazing life. You can go to the Super Bowl. You can have an incredible wedding. You can go to the best parties. You can go through 11 fertility treatments that aren't covered by insurance because a doctor told you you can never have children. Yep. This old boy here, my oldest, is a fertility miracle. Doctors told me we couldn't have kids. And I said, that's bullshit. That's your world. That's you're looking at some report. Miracles happen, and we never gave up. Folks, never give up. Then we adopted this little cutie from China. We wouldn't be able to do that if we didn't make the money that we made from real estate. So taking them to the World Series, going to WWE, sitting ringside with my boys, sending them to private schools and the best schools money can buy, getting them the best coaches, taking the greatest vacations. That's why you should be committed, not just interested in mastering the ability to generate leads. It doesn't matter where you are. I came from nothing. I came from worse than nothing. I had over $50,000 in debt. So here's the learning curve. Lead generation is a skill. Skills can be learned. You work, you come on today's webinar, that's great. Your skill improves. You made some distinctions. Right in the box, I made some distinctions. That's fantastic. If you don't stay at it, the skill falls off. You come on another webinar that I do in a month, your skill will improve again. You come on again, it improves. And over time, it goes up. My son plays football. If he takes 3 or 4 months off, his skill drops. He's going to stay at it. I'm going next week to Nashville, Tennessee to a marketing seminar. I understand this shit, folks, but I'm always looking for the cutting edge, the finite little distinction. So I'm spending several thousands of dollars leaving my wife and my children, leaving my home, leaving my business to invest in me and learn how to improve my skills in lead generation. I also want to leave you with this. You're the average of the people you spend time with. So do you spend time with winners, people that lift you up, or do you spend time with people that pull you down? Do you know the story about crabs in a bucket? Crabs can't get out of the bucket. Even though he's right here at the top, he can grab it and pull himself out, but he can't get out because the other crabs pull them down. So I want you to make a list. Do you have crabs in your marketplace that are pulling you down, telling you you can't do it? Or do you have people that tell you, that believe in you and tell you you can do it? So I appreciate you coming today. I told you I'd offer you some resources. We have an online program, and this is no heavy sales pitch. I just want to let you know it's available. It's called the Ultimate Real Estate Blueprint. It's loaded with 35 lessons, dozens and dozens of hours of training videos like this on business planning and goal setting, buyer mastery, seller mastery, lead generation, and loaded with bonuses. We sell it online for $3,000. You can go on there. We'll give you the blueprint. We'll give you some bonus. We'll give you some swipe files, and it's $3,000. You don't have to take our word for it. We have agents all over the country using it, U.S. and Canada. But I don't want you to buy it because we've created an inner circle. Now, the ultimate real estate blueprint is $3,000, but that's always the wrong question. You should ask, what is it worth? Not what does it cost? And here it is online, through $29.97. You can go to the ultimate real estate blueprint, but don't buy it. Because we created an inner circle program, and we're doing a group coaching program, an inner circle, where we give you the ultimate real estate blueprint for free, instantly. So you can go through it, you can consume it at your leisure, you can study up your skills on lead generation, marketing, we'll give you all the swipe files. It's got buyer mastery, seller mastery, lead generation examples, so everything that I have here. It's got scripts, processes, systems. You can print it out. It is the best real estate resource library on the planet today. Nobody's doing it. So you get all that, $3,000 plus some additional training, and 2 live calls per month with me if you join the inner circle. And we've made it available to you today for $197 down and $197 a month. So simply put, $394 gets you in, and then $197 a month. Now, your comfort zone, where are you today? Are you safe and comfortable? Are you fear? Are you in the learning zone, or are you in the growth zone? I'm going to suggest you jump into the growth zone. You join me, and you go to www.brianmosesinnercircle.com. Thor just wrote, Brian, it's Thor. I have 2 new leads from yesterday, $2.65 each so far. Pretty good job, Thor. Great job. Thor and I just created an ad yesterday on our one-on-one coaching call, so he's got 2 great leads. So I want you guys to go to www.brianmosesinnercircle.com. I'll chat it to you. You can all click on that link, open it up in another browser, read about it, but more importantly, say, yes, I want to join Brian's inner circle, 2 calls a month with me, access to a private Facebook group, all the trainings that you need to get to 100 transactions or more per year. It's all available for you. You guys have been fantastic. I'll stick around. Does anybody have any questions? What about the recorded library? Yes, Wes, the recorded library is included in the Inner Circle program for $197 down and $197 a month. And we sell it for $3,000. So pretty good deal. We'll give you free access to it. All right, gang, if you have any questions, you can certainly email me, brian@brianmoses.com. Have a great day, everybody. Appreciate you joining me. Bye-bye.